Blackstone Publishing presents The Old Religion by Martyn Waits. This book is read by Martyn Waits.
Part 1. Chapter 1. Kyle Tanner opened his eyes, peering out from the back of a deep, dark cave, breathing jagged and heavy, body not his own, head not his own. He was walking, staggering. Where? Why? Memory came back in fragments. Globs of paint dropped on a canvas, forming only an incomplete picture. His two mates, a campsite. Then there was a girl. Small, pretty, nice smile. And some kind of spliff. Strong. Nauseatingly, sickeningly strong. Felt the smoke in his lungs, the heat prickling, stinging, head spinning, and then... nothing. He kept walking, stumbling, going nowhere, waiting for more paint to fall, fill in the landscape. Then he heard something, a voice. Someone was talking to him. He turned, trying to trace the source. I said... do you want a lift? It was the girl, with the smile and the spliff. Lily? Lila? Leaning out of the window on the passenger side of a VW camper van. My mates went back ages ago, she said. Come on, get in. He did so, grateful not to have to walk. The van pulled away, and Kyle Tanner was never seen alive again. Chapter 2. The waves roiled and pushed towards the bay, dragging with them the threat of danger and violence to a rising accompaniment of white noise. Some didn't make the shore, crashing against the lumpen rock outliers, breaking on the cliff faces, bursting upwards and outwards, all white spume and foam. A crescendoing explosion of static, sheer primal power. Whatever was left made it through to the shore, curling and unfolding, then lying down flat, thin and spent, their threat, their power, gone. Then the sea clawed them back once more, starting the whole process all over again. Tom Killgannon watched from a clifftop, hooded, bundled. His bad weather gear was supposed to keep him insulated, impassive to the elements. But it didn't. Even with the hood of his waterproof pulled over his head, the rain stung his exposed features, hurled into his face by gales threatening to uproot trees and upend people. Icy needles shattering against his skin. He wished he could be as impervious to the elements as the rocks below were to the waves. But he wasn't. Nowhere near. The clouds were low, dark and heavy. They leached the colour from the surrounding landscape, rendered the world a perpetual twilight. Black birds wheeled, caught in the airstream, cawing, a murder of angry dots. Tom weathered the elements, stood his ground, watched the bay below. Some desperate surfers had got themselves into wetsuits and were running down over the shingle towards the sea, racing each other to be the furthest out, fastest in. Idiots, he thought. Why would they want to court life-altering injuries or even death by hurling themselves against nature at its angriest? What did they have to prove, to themselves or anyone else? What was lacking in their lives that drove them to do that? He didn't know. Didn't want to speculate. Just knew that these people hadn't faced real horror in their lives, real danger. If they had, the last thing they would do was actively seek it out. He checked his watch, turned away from the cliff face, the surfers and their stupid death wishes dismissed. Time to go to work. The sailmaker's pub was all but empty. Sunday quiet. No roasts, no specials. No tourists ventured this way, especially out of season, so no point. just the few daytime regulars, scattered and disparate, who would brave more than the storm outside to get their usual seat, their usual drink. Tom came through the front door, closed it behind.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.